I remember in graduate school, sometimes doing experiments until quite late into the evening, 11 p.m., midnight, 1 a.m., and I get this very exciting result. It actually really is a thrill, it's a high. And I remember just walking home and sleeping and being incredibly excited to wake up very early the next morning and start the next experiment. And that's really what keeps me going.
There's like this camaraderie and a very supportive environment that Walum and OHSU has created, which has definitely been inspiring. We've been inspiring in terms of sort of asking questions that, you know, I hadn't thought of earlier. And that's kind of what collaboration means, right? Which is that you bring two people who have strengths in completely independent fields, but come together and ask a question that, you know, maybe independently it's a bit more challenging to answer.
I've worked with a wonderful group of cardiologists. I've worked with statisticians, advanced quantitative methodologists, many nursing scientists. I feel very committed to helping Oregonians live better lives. I think what sets people in Portland and then in the greater state apart is that people are very generous. Patients are very generous with their time and giving willingness to give for research.
My research focuses on optical coherence tomography, or OCT. OCT is an imaging modality that I co-invented 30 years ago when I was a student at MIT. The speed of OCT scanning is now 1,000 times faster than the original version that I developed. Can see tissue with new contrast. We have more powerful diagnostic tests that we can develop, and that excites me.
We really want to be able to translate some of those technologies that we are working on the lab and just take them out of the ivory tower, the research ivory tower. We want to actually get those products to actually help people. I mean, that's the main goal of what we do.
What I see in the clinic really informs the science that I pursue, and then I'm able to take those clinical observations to the lab and then take the basic science findings that I have and translate them hopefully back to the clinical setting in terms of how physicians can diagnose, treat, and then hopefully prevent certain disease processes from happening.
I really am looking forward to seeing more of the work that we've done, the biological foundation that we have done in studying blood cancers be translated into the clinical realm. We are developing a better and better understanding of how we might apply novel therapeutics to block these switches and these triggers.
The main objective at the end of the day, we would like to understand to the extent that eventually we will be able to design strategies to combat those diseases caused by pathogens like viruses, SARS-CoV-2, it could be Zika virus, it could be dengue or HIV.
There's over, you know, 1.5 million adolescents presenting to emergency departments who are suicidal or their parents are out of answers. The research that we're doing is a little bit of a out-of-the-box, blue sky kind of thing. It's kind of thinking outside the box to use things that adolescents are already doing, so we're not completely changing how they function and act at home, and trying to introduce more preventative measures to their care. And so my hope is if we can kind of build out the science and the clinical studies behind it, it could actually be something that could be used in real life for adolescents and families that are incredibly struggling.
What really gets my blood pumping is the possibility of addressing complex challenges. It's really thinking of innovative solutions that can actually have an impact on people's lives, and the ability of actually taking things that are complicated and have been challenging for a number of years and just tackling them as best as we can and seeing the immediate impact that those findings and discoveries can have in the way that we practice medicine, dentistry, and healthcare in general.